Hey guys, welcome back. It's Katarina. Hope you're all having a great day so far. Today is going to be another part of my One Brand Favorites series, and today we're going to be talking all about City Color Cosmetics. So let's get started. If you didn't see my last One Brand Favorites, it was all on Maybelline, so I will link that video down below or right up top over here. But basically, it's where I talk about one brand, and I just choose any brand, and I go through all of my favorites from that brand, just because I know makeup shopping can be very overwhelming. There's so many products in the makeup industry, so I wanted to create this series to kind of help everyone out and kind of break things down. That way, if you're curious about trying, especially like a new brand or something, you can have somebody's opinion, see some swatches maybe before you make purchases. So when I did my Maybelline One Brand Favorites, I asked you guys what you wanted to see next, and literally like 95% of you said City Color Cosmetics. And City Color Cosmetics is a brand that I talk about a lot here on my channel, and I discovered them through Ipsy 2 years ago now, I think it was, last year or 2 years ago, with one of their Be Matte blushes, and I was so hooked on that blush, I started buying more. That's how I discovered the brand, and I have accumulated a lot of products. So I'm going to take you through all of my favorites. I'm also going to take you through a couple misses, just because I do have different formulas, for example, lipsticks or eyeshadow palettes. That way it can kind of give you an idea, because City Color Cosmetics is an online only company. You can start to slowly find them at, I believe, like Five Below and Under stores. Somebody told me that. I haven't seen them yet because I don't have any of those stores there. So you do buy them online. So hopefully this video can kind of help you out. I'll take you through as many swatches as I can of things. I'll do close-ups of every single thing that I'm talking about just to really show you. And yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy this video, and let's get started. I want to start with what, again, drew me into this brand and my very first product that I tried from this brand, because that's what created my obsession. So, in my Ipsy bag, I said, I think like a year ago, 2 years ago, I received this Be Matte blush in this shade right here. This is the shade Watermelon. These blushes, number one, are huge. They come in 0.341 ounces. The typical blush is about 0.12 ounces, or very similar to that. And I do have a whole review video on a couple of these blushes. I'll link it down below, along with any time that I do have a review, swatch video, or demonstration of me using these products. I will pop it right up here and link it in the description box so you guys can check it out. This one right here is Fresh Melon. It is the most beautiful, kind of like neon watermelon shade. It looks beautiful in the summertime, especially with a tan, because it is very bright in your face, but it just adds so much warmth to the skin. And now the Be Matte line of blushes does have, I believe, about 10 blushes in their line now. I do have 6 of them, but I'm just going to take you through a couple. So my all-time favorite blush though is Sweet Pea. This shade is just that perfect everyday kind of neutral with a very slight mauve undertone. It is what I have on my cheeks today, along with Sunset Safari, but it's just that perfect everyday blush. I feel like this is such a staple in the collection because it'll suit so many different skin tones and also so many different makeup looks. These blushes retail for $4.99, so very affordable as well. And then quickly, I also wanted to mention this one to you guys. It's in the shade Blackberry, because I have used this so much in so many different tutorials because I find it to be a very unique shade. It is a very beautiful plummy purple pink, and it is so stunning on the cheeks. Now, on the contrary to loving matte blushes, I also do really like cream blushes, but it's really hard to find those cream blushes that are actually going to go on, stay all day, and not be blotchy. So they do have a bunch in their collection. I do have 4 of them here, but one of my favorites is this shade right here. It is in the shade Mixed Berry Sorbet, and I just like it because it's such a unique shade. It's almost like a bronzer shade to me, but it has a hint of kind of like taupey mauve in there, so it's very unique. I'm very into shades like this, and I did also use this today on my lips in conjunction with a lip product that I'm going to talk about as well. But this formula is very creamy, very hydrating, and very moisturizing. City Color Cosmetics is also a brand that is just really affordable. That's why I really appreciate their products, because they're affordable, but their products are very high quality as well. You really get a bang for your buck. I want to quickly jump over to highlighters, because that's also something that I'm very excited about. So they do have 3 different formulas on their site. They have a liquid formula, they have a cream formula, and then also powder formulas. So right off the bat, I do have to say the liquid formulas are not my favorite. They are a little bit hard for me to blend out. I do love the colors, especially this one right here, which is in the shade Blushed Wine, but I just find these to be a little bit harder to blend out onto my skin and not look as natural. But if you are looking for a very intense highlight, definitely try their highlighting wands. So this will be no surprise here, but these 2 highlighting products, and especially together, are just my holy grail highlighting products. And the best part is these two combined is less than $10. So this right here is a City Color Spotlight Highlight. I have most definitely hit pan on this. This is very similar to MAC's Shell Highlighter. It's that same consistency, same pearl champagne shade, and it's just beautiful. I really like applying that first, which is what I have on today, and then I like to go in with the City Color Highlighting Trio. This trio, I believe, is around $8.99. And it comes with three different shades. Comes with a beautiful kind of pinkish undertone pearl, typical champagne, and then a beautiful gold. I really like to use these ones right down here over top of the cream highlighter for an extra oomph of highlight, and it just lasts all day long. These are very opaque, very creamy, very blendable. Just cannot say enough good things about this highlighter. I also want to quickly shout out their brow duo. Now, I use this a bunch before I got the Salon Perfect Brow Pomade. Now I'm really into the pomades because it's so easy for me to do. But I did use this today not only on my brows to like set the tail area, but I also use both these shades on my eyes today. I use this as my all-over crease shade and this as my defining shade on the outer V over here. They are beautiful, they are matte, they are very creamy and blendable and very opaque as well. So I wanted to mention their City Color Shadow Primer. Now this primer I especially like, I also did hit pan on this as well, because it has a silicone base, so it has kind of a tacky formula, which I really like. I like to do this all over my lid, then set it with a powder, and then go in with my eyeshadows. If you don't set it with a powder, it can tend to kind of crease with those shadows, just because it is more of that tacky silicone base, but this makes your shadows just pop, makes them last all day long, and again, this is like $3.99. The Correct and Perfect palette from City Color Cosmetics I wanted to mention because although I don't find this to be a holy grail product, this middle shade right here, the green, which I do believe that they sell separately in a tube, is amazing. I use it so much for a lot of my redness, especially acne scarring or just current breakouts, any redness that you have, maybe around your nose. This shade is stunning. I will not repurchase this full-on kit because I don't find myself really reaching for the other shade as much as I thought I would, but I will definitely be purchasing the green again. Wanted to jump into lips really quick. You would think I had a bunch from them, but for some reason, I don't. Now, I want to talk about first my favorite formula is the City Color City Chic lipsticks. This shade is in The Secret Affair, and this shade is gorgeous. It is the most beautiful combination of plum, berry, wine, red is in there, and it's just a very creamy formula. It does have a very strong scent of SPF, though, so if that does bother you, then you probably won't like this, but I personally like it. It smells very fresh, but it's very hydrating. The formula kind of reminds me of the NYX Rand lipsticks, just not as creamy, because sometimes those can be too creamy where you put them on and all of a sudden your lipstick's gone because it's so creamy. Out of all of City Color's lipsticks, formulas that they have, and finishes, I definitely recommend trying the City Color City Chic. A very similar one to that color if you are into more mattes, this is their City Color B Matte Lipstick, and this is in the shade Denise. So I believe all the shades are names, and again, it's that very similar kind of cranberry shade, but this one is just a little bit lighter. Completely matte, very creamy, they're very hydrating for being matte lipsticks, and they have a really good shade selection as well, and very, very affordable. What I do have on my lips today is a City Color Matte to Gloss. This was very intriguing to me because I know matte lips are very on trend right now, but I also like to have that gloss option just because sometimes I really want a glossy lip like I did today. But this is a really nice duo because it is the same colors on both sides, only two different kind of formulas. So this is in the shade Mauve Dazzle. So the gloss is what I have over top of that one stick blush that I was just talking about, but it's just a very beautiful kind of mauve, taupey, neutral shade. But I do have to say, packaging wise, I don't know if they're going to all be like that, but this did tip off. So that is definitely something to think about. The other lipsticks were very well made in their packaging. This one just happened to, I think what happened is I think I twirled it up all the way and then kind of applied my lipstick generously and aggressively, so that popped out. I did have a bronzer, one of the B Matte blushes, as a bronzer. It was in the shade Toasted Coconut. I used all of that up, so I also wanted to try one of their, this is actually a cream foundation, and I got it in the shade Mocha because I wanted to try out cream contouring, and it does, again, have a very, very strong SPF scent with a little bit of a fragrance in there. The scent I'm really not too fond of, to be quite honest, but it doesn't break out my skin or irritate my skin, so that's what I really care about because my skin's very sensitive. But this is a beautiful shade for cream contouring. I did use it today to cream contour. It adds a lot of warmth and bronziness to the skin, and I'm going to especially be using this a lot in the winter months because my skin tends to get a little bit more dry because I do naturally have more oily skin. The best part to me is eyes, which I have quite a few different palettes here to talk about and products here. I'm going to start off with what I use on my eyes today, and one of my my favorite products from City Color Cosmetics in general, and it is their City Color Timeless Palette. This is a stunning palette with a huge mirror as well, but you get these three beautiful blushes, slash bronzers, slash highlighters, and then you get four trios of eyeshadows. I use this trio on my eyes today to kind of create a soft gold smoky eye. I do have a whole review and full-on swatches of this video. Again, I will pop it right up here if you guys want to check that out to see close-ups of all of these in action and everything like that. This is just such a staple, I feel like, because there's so many different colors in here and beautiful shimmery highlighters. This is definitely a must-have in my opinion. Another palette that I love from them, especially for this time of the year and the fall time, is the Spice Me Up palette. These are very spicy shades, and I think I told you guys before, but this middle brown shade right here is just everything to me. It is so pigmented, so creamy. It has almost like a kind of purplish undertone in there, and it's just a very rich tone brown, and I love it. Then the last thing I wanted to talk about is their new shimmer shadows. These recently launched and they are amazing, you guys. They're almost like foil shadows just because they are so pigmented and kind of metallic-y. But they also do have, I believe, a couple of matte ones like this one in Black Widow. But my favorite one, and I did use it in a tutorial, is in the shade Cheers to Life. It is the most beautiful, deep, deep gold, and I love this so much for applying it all over the lid. It really makes your brown eyes pop, and I think it'd be beautiful on green eyes as well. It's also gorgeous. It's the shade All Eyes on Me. I think this would be beautiful on all eye colors and really make your eyes pop, especially if you have blue eyes or gray eyes. I feel like this would be gorgeous. Yeah, I really hope that you guys enjoy this video. Those are all of my favorite products from City Color Cosmetics. I have definitely not tried their whole entire line because that is a lot of makeup, but I wanted to just kind of share what my current favorites are because I know I talk about them a lot on my channel, and a lot of you have been kind of curious about what my favorites are and maybe if I could do combine them all in one video. I did also want to let you know that I do have a 10% coupon code with City Color Cosmetics for you guys. It is just Katarina13. I am affiliated with them, but I first discovered their products without knowing who they were or anything from that Ipsy bag, that Fresh Melon. And then from that blush, I started buying more and more products. And then slowly over time, they kind of noticed that as well. And we started collaborating and I became an affiliate with them just because I genuinely 100% adore their products. And they're so affordable. You guys know I'm always on the hunt for affordable products. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a big thumbs up if you did. And let me know in the comments down below what one brand favorites you'd like to see next. And I'll see you guys in my next video.